when somebody has Siakam at like what, the 8th best power forward in the NBA or something like that?
I mean, ain't much changed.
Well, I'll tell you why he's a lot better than that once you get to him on my list.
So you 8? What's your 8?
Yeah, drop your 8, Derek.
Spicy P. I had him at number 8. I wanted to see a little bit more. I feel like all the guys above him are more established, and I've seen more consistency from them. I feel like he's
you say
good.
That often, right?
Yeah.
I want to see more. What more do you want to see?
Mm-hmm.
Like,
I
want to
see him in his number one option type role.
Is that him though?
But that's what I want to say.
So everybody else above him on his list, on your list, is their number one option?
No. Most of them have been there on their career.
So you're taking into consideration everything they've done in their lifetime instead of like the last season or two.
Yep.
Okay.
Then why is Paul Millsap not on your list?
He is on my list.
Oh.
Oh.
He was like, he was an honorable mention on my list.
He was not mentioned for me too. So, okay. So that means you ain't got like Aaron Gordon. I mean, you ain't got like John Collins.
No, I don't.
Who did Derek?
I had Millsap at 7.
Okay.
Just because of the simple fact that defensively he kind of holds that Denver team together.
True.
And he was kind of the reason why they were a legit playoff team, because the year they didn't have him, they missed the playoffs.
Yeah.
And the year they had him, now they're the second seed.
Can I ask you a question?
No.
And is you know, just a simple question. Is there anything that Paul Millsap did last year that Pascal Siakam didn't do? Because, I mean, even from a statistical point, I don't see anything he did.
No, he didn't. I'm not going to lie.
Personally, me. You have every right to put him on your list. But personally, for me, it's not nothing he did better than Aaron Gordon.
Mm-hmm.
It's not nothing he did better than Pascal Siakam, Lauri Markkanen, John Collins. And those guys are young. Those are guys like...
And against another competitive team like the Raptors, and they did not disappoint. That fourth quarter, they really came out. And luckily for them, Marcus Gasol is terrible defensively, I guess. At least he was last night. And he does not grab any rebounds, at least last night.
And he didn't score either at one point.
Oh, he didn't score? See, I didn't even know he didn't even score. Damn. Yeah,
shot literally 0% from the field.
Yikes.
Derek, after these two games, do you have anything different to say about Pascal?
34 in the first game, 33 in this one.
He played solid.
He played solid.
He played very good. Okay, I'll
That's
say
like
he played
leading
very
the league
good.
In scoring good. What are you talking okay, about?
But it's just two games. I'm not going to sit here and like praise him.
So let's say consistency is a part of being that.
If he would have played bad, I would be like, it's just two games.
So let's say, okay, for example, let's say he's not going to average 33. But let's say he averages 25 and the team is good like they are. They're decent. Do you change that opinion?
Yeah, but he's not going to average 25.
So what is he going to average?
Wasn't he like a 17-point scorer last year?
He's got way more opportunity now.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. He's literally scoring 30 each game.
Yeah, but when y'all looked at him last year with playing with Kawhi, did y'all ever look at him and say, damn, if Kawhi wasn't here, this dude would be going crazy? Like, when they was in the playoffs, when he was struggling, Kawhi was carrying that whole team, would y'all ever look at him and be like, damn, if Kawhi wasn't here,
the difference
it would
is,
be crazy to see Pascal by himself. Nobody was ever looking at him like that.
Last year, he only took 12 shots a game. This year, he's taking 20-plus.
Yeah. Right.
Opportunity's there. He's efficient with it.
That's why the conversation is up, because you know Kawhi is not going to be there.
Right.
Because
he has
Why
the
would
shots.
You have that conversation if Kawhi is there?
But yeah, because
the conversation didn't start until we saw Kawhi is not going to be there. Now that whole thing opens up. And who else is going to get those shots?
Him and Fred VanVleet been sharing them.
Yeah. Yeah, but I
so
feel like
you asking us how we, why, because
not only are the shots he's getting from like Kyle Lowry and Fred VanVleet just passing the ball up ahead, but he's getting the rebound and going.
And he's
so
shooting
he's basically like doubling the shots.
I have nothing wrong with how you feel or what you believe. My only thing was, don't say he played okay when a motherfucker just gave us 34 and 33. Then he's shooting 50% from the field, 5 of 7 from 3, 71% from 3. 71% from 3, and you talking about, he played all right. Like, don't do that. Believe what you want to believe. I think you got a good point that it's only been two games, because I would say the same thing.
Mm-hmm.
I
a lot of players come out in the beginning.
We got to talk about game 7 first, because that's like the biggest thing that happened. Me and Mike watched this game together, and I tell you, Mike was super funny with it. I wouldn't say hot takes, but just had some opinions out there that were like kind of a little bit crazy, but not that crazy when you really think about it. And a lot of it had to do with like Pascal Siakam, right, Mike?
Oh yeah.
I was screaming at Pascal the whole game, because every time I see this man, he's trying to go to his right. It don't matter what type of defender. Okay, Jaylen Brown's been clamping him up on the block, but I see players like Brad Wanamaker stopping this man from getting to the paint because he can't go to his left. And I was screaming at the top of my lungs when this man had a bucket with his left hand. He had to put the ball in his left he had some dribbles with it too and finished with the left. I was so happy for him, but I wish he could have had a better game. But I mean, I don't know, man. Pascal, you got some work to do in this offseason, buddy.
Yeah, hey, I was watching this game and I was on the screen. And I was like, it's crazy that I'm saying that I want the all-star on the other team to shoot the ball. Like, I want him to shoot the ball. That's kind of crazy to even think that he's the guy that you're just like, all right, I'm going to let him beat me. Because he wasn't making anything. He hasn't made anything all series. He's been consistently bad this whole series. And it's just very unfortunate to see it. This is kind of why I made that opinion last year when I said he can't be a number one option. Because when I saw him in that Warriors series, when Draymond kind of took him out the series after game one, you kind of just saw that once you kind of go for his right hand and you kind of stop him, because he ain't got that shot creation skills. So it's kind of why I made that hot take last year. And he kind of
But you didn't say all that when you made that.
I know. Right. I'm a little bit better now. I grew a little bit. You know, that's self-improvement.
That's a fact, D-Mills. It's a fact.
I grew a little bit, P. I'm no longer that little boy no more.
I don't want to give Pascal Siakam.
You can't reference your take then if that was a little boy take.
Bro, that was like, how long was that? How long?
It wasn't that long.
That was like after the finals.
Yeah. Almost
like
a year.
It was like off season.
That was New York. That was New York, the Twitter show.
Yeah.
Oh, so like, right. Season. I mean, that's like a year ago now. Yeah, I think about it because that was October. Wow. Yeah. So last year.
Coming to Chicago. I want to turn my focus to D Mills just for a quick second. I don't want to pick on my boy, but you know, he be having some shit that be making me like, eh.
This is like all time.
If y'all remember, we have an episode. We do the top 10 ranking at every position. And my boy D Mills had Pascal Siakam fairly low.
At number 8.
He had him at 8.
8th best power forward in the whole league, really?
Over Paul Millsap and Kevin Love.
Who barely played last year. I don't understand it, but I'm going to let him explain himself. But before you even do you still have those low expectations for Pascal Siakam, knowing that he just got the bag and that Kawhi is not there?
To be honest, I have high expectations for Pascal now, just because of the simple fact that he did get the bag and that Kawhi is gone, Danny Green is gone. So now he has to come out and really show that he could be the number one option for a championship team.
You know what's crazy?
That was a championship team, at least.
I have no doubt in my mind that Pascal can do that.
Yeah, do you? There's something that you don't see in him for him.
Offensively, he struggles to create for himself. So I feel like he's not a consistent perimeter shooter. So how can he really be your number one option? So I personally feel like he cannot be your number one option.
Let's ask the fans. Because Pascal Siakam be your number one option?
Thank you. I am not crazy.
but maybe in a situation, like I said, they're using the Clippers model, right? They give Pascal Siakam this bag, but with all this contract space opening up for 2021, he's back to your second option, right? That can
potentially
be a situation.
But when has that big free agent went to Toronto?
It could happen.
That's a fact.
But it never happens.
I agree.
So why didn't it happen? Why never even wanted to go down?
I agree with that point. But listen,
that's true.
I'm a boil down to this because I know they're going off the fact that this season, I don't think Pascal Siakam is going to be it this season, but they signed him for the future. So you don't see any chance of him being a number one option at all?
Nope. I think he's going to be a solid number two, number three.
Big question. What do you consider a number one option? What is number one option numbers? And I'll tell you if he can do it.
When you look at the young guys, you look at guys who could really carry the load offensively, like a Donovan Mitchell, D-Buck, like the guys who you can give them the ball and say, hey.
But those are guards.
Yeah,
I know.
It's
a bit different when it's a guard, right?
That's fine. There's fours that can do it too.
Like?
LeBron, AD.
Oh, you talking superstar.
He's got to take his step to the next game. Obviously, we want him to be a more consistent shooter, but he wants him to have his own ability to create his own shot.
He has to be able to carry the load for a team. I personally just don't think he's shown enough to where he can carry the load for a team.
Let me tell you this. His top 3 points scored in a single game, all of them without Kawhi in the lineup last year. That's all I got to say.
Actually, I got to put something like that. That's not 82.
If the game is on the line and say you have 5 seconds left, you give it to Kyle Lowry or you give it to Pascal?
I'm giving it to Kyle Lowry.
I love Kyle Lowry.
So Pascal Siakam is not a number one option to you?
No, not at all.
That's cap.
Yeah, I'm going to agree with Kenny. That's cap. That's more cap than Lids in the new era. But speaking of cap, we got a fan favorite segment that we do here Through the Wire called Cap or No Cap.
But even after that, going into this season, before that, when we had like the ranking power forwards, he had Pascal Siakam pretty low. Paul Millsap, who was like super important in the comeback yesterday, was higher than Pascal Siakam.
Kevin Love was too.
Kevin Love, yeah.
Kevin Love was in my top 5 too.
And I'm guessing you don't still stand on those type of takes.
No.
Okay. Okay. Either way, I don't want to give Pascal Siakam an excuse, but this is something that I should probably say. During this entire quarantine period, he did not touch a basketball. And you can say the same about guys like Jason Tatum. Jason Tatum also didn't touch a basketball. But Jason Tatum is like naturally gifted at the game, and Pascal Siakam isn't. all the things that we've seen about Pascal Siakam is about the hard work he puts in the offseason. There's nothing like really natural about Pascal Siakam's game. It never has been. So taking 4 or 5 months without touching a basketball really hurt him. Again, I mean, he's an NBA player and he was an all-star, so you'd expect him to be better in a series, even all things considered. But like that did play a big part in it. He's just not naturally talented. He's a guy that has to put that work in, which is okay. Everybody's not naturally talented. And you really saw that in this series, man.
Yeah, people need to be a little patient with Pascal Siakam because he's not, like you said, he's not a natural guy. He hasn't been bred to be that guy. So even the question of that lady asking was pretty wild to me because, yeah, he didn't play to his level. But I also know that I'm not putting everything on Pascal Siakam to take us home. And if anybody was doing that or trying to do that, then they were out of their mind. Besides the actual coaches. I mean, Nick Nurse has to do what he has to do. But as a fan, if you're like, hey, Pascal going to take us home, I don't know why you were ever thinking that. I just don't get that, especially against the Celtics who have Tatum, Brown, and Walker. And you think Pascal is going to – no, he's not a guy that's taking out those three by himself.
I like Nick.
Then last one. I don't even know who my lesson to agree with. The opposite. So who's the worst kept secret? Who's the motherfucker that's just like, he good, but y'all motherfuckers got him on shit. Like, he ain't. Like, he like, y'all, he, you know what I'm saying?
A guy I've given criticism before, Siakam.
Kind of always. The world has changed on Siakam this season, bro.
But I just feel like he's always been kind of mid.
he already been kind of mid.
Last year, but.
Always? No, last year he was great.
Last year was pretty good. And then it just kind of seems like his game is always like a way that you could defend it. Like I was watching him last year, it kind of seemed like you could still defend this if you have the right scheme. And now teams know exactly what he's about to do and what his go-to moves are. And you can see it's definitely affecting him.
That's a really good pick. He makes it so hard for himself.
Yeah.
He just wants to try to take the difficult shot when in reality.
So in today's episode of Through the Wire, we are doing power forwards. We're doing power forwards today. We've done point guard, shooting guard, small forwards, and y'all seem to love it. And doing my power forward list made me remember a crazy moment from the beginning of the season when we did our list, where somebody had Siakam and like, what, the 8th best power forward in the NBA or something like that?
I mean, ain't much changed.
What? Who did he have above him? I think it was like Paul Millsap.
Paul Millsap, Kevin Love. Still the top dogs.
I guess we'll find out. I guess we'll find out because we all...
If a team was looking at him...
You gave to your make fifth, a, Mike?
My fifth was Bam.
Yeah, my fifth is Pascal. I got Pascal Siakam. In
that's progression.
Five.
That's like... character development. He went from almost last on your list to number 5.
Hey, man, he's shown that he can be a number one option. He's shooting the three ball well.
He can now.
We got it out the horse's mouth.
I want to hear the people above him still.
He's amazing.
He's amazing. What a turnaround. What a turnaround for y'all that do not know. We did a bunch of rehearsals before like the regular season started in New York for our Twitter show. And though they don't see these, it was you were talking a lot of shit about Pascal Siakam and these rehearsals.
I was just
runs.
Saying
that's
that he
why
had
the rehearsals
to prove it.
Were bad because he kind of toned it down.
He yeah, he definitely turned it down once we were live. Definitely turned it down.
Oh, I got the crowd involved. I asked them, am I tripping for saying Pascal Siakam is not a number one option? They said, no.
It was one dude.
No, it was the whole crowd. Okay. It was the whole crowd.
And then that night, what did he do? He dropped 40.
He's talking about the whole crowd agreeing with him on that.
Hell, there's no way the whole crowd agrees with
lying.
You.
Okay.
No reason.
Yeah, not.
Yeah. Go talk. Yeah. Go talk. Yeah. Go talk, my nigga. It's go talk. Go talk. Go talk. Go talk, my nigga. That's go talk. Go talk. Go talk. Go talk, my nigga. It's go talk.
Go talk. Go talk. Go talk, my nigga. It's go talk.
You got to bring up that spin, man. Gotta bring up that spin.
I know players have their go-to moves, but usually they have something else.